Too many are wondering if the dream of a middle-class life, that American dream, is slipping away.
It's the which is already helping some 300,000 veterans and their family members pursue their dream of a college education. And for veterans trying to find work in a very tough economy.
Putting a middle-class tax cut in the pockets of 95% of working families. And we're providing a $2,500 annual tax credit to put the dream of a college degree or advanced training within the reach for more students. That's why I was committed to health care reform as a presidential candidate. That's why health care reform is a key priority to this presidency. That's why I will not rest until the dream of health care reform is finally achieved in the United States of America. And that Brown was, of course, the first major step in dismantling the separate but equal doctrine. But it would take a number of years and a nationwide movement to fully realize the dream of civil rights for all of God's children.
The dream of opportunity for all people has not come true for everyone in America, but its promise exists for all who come to our shores. And that includes nearly 7 million American Muslims in our country today, who, by the way, enjoy incomes and educational levels that are higher than the American average.
And as you could see when we went down to the garden, can you imagine how thriving that garden is, just how much food grew from a few little seeds and some plantings? So this was a big dream of mine for a while, and it's been so much fun working with you all.
The dream of opportunity for all people has not come true for everyone in America, but its promise exists for all who come to our shores. And that includes nearly 7 million American Muslims in our country today, who, by the way, enjoy incomes and educational levels that are higher than the American average. Owners
had little more than a dream of opening up a casual pizza restaurant. They found it challenging to get financing. Ultimately, they got a loan through City First Bank, a community.
It's always been a dream of mine to visit the most prestigious school in Cambridge, Massachusetts.
We refuse to believe that our politics are too broken to make the energy future we dream of a reality.
I know trillions of dollars in savings have been lost, forcing seniors to put off retirement, young people to postpone college, entrepreneurs to give up on the dream of starting a company.
And as it will take all of us coming together in the spirit of Earth Day, not only on Earth Day, but every day, to make the dream of a clean energy economy and a clean world a reality.
He's been funding that scholarship ever since, helping to make the dream of college a reality for students in his hometown.
Dream of brighter days ahead, a faith in things not seen, a belief that here in this country we are the authors of our own destiny. That
we just knew our dream of it, or we probably would have been too intimidated. Tonight, it is my distinct pleasure to present America's highest award for popular music on behalf of a grateful nation, grateful that a young Englishman shared his dreams with us, Sir Paul McCartney.
That includes funding the post-9/11 GI Bill, which is already helping more than 300,000 veterans and family members pursue their dream of a college education.
Our future will be more secure if anybody who's willing to work hard is able to achieve their dream of getting a college education.
Kathleen and Edward Mohan to give their daughter Sarah the education she needs to pursue her her dream of becoming a nurse. So all these families have benefited directly.
It was hard for young people to learn, where the dream of college was out of reach for too many, where there was a culture of failure that brought everybody down.
I can say that even at the dearth of, even at the nadir of the valley of death, we never lost hope, and we never lost our dream of reestablishing a sovereign state in our ancient homeland, the land of Israel. And now,
if there's anyone out there who still doubts that Ireland is a place where all things are possible, who still wonders if the dream of our ancestors is alive in our time, who still questions our capacity to restore ourselves, to reinvent ourselves, and to prosper, well, today is your answer.
Finally, that's why we're making sure that all of our children can afford to fulfill their dream of a college education, that they can afford to go to school, and that Pell Grants and student loan programs ensure that they don't come out of college with mountains of debt. Dream of making the desert bloom. He and his wife, Sonia, were part of the generation that achieved it.
The dream, most actors dream of being in maybe one film that becomes part of our cultural vocabulary.
As an adult, she's built a career the Hardy Boys could only dream of.
Today, the sons of Abraham and the daughters of Sarah are fulfilling the dream of the ages, to be masters of their own fate in their own sovereign state. And just as we have for these past 65 years, the United States is proud to stand with you as your strongest ally and your greatest friend.
As you said earlier today, the essence of the State of Israel, the essence of the rebirth of the Jewish state, is the fulfillment of the age-old dream of the Jewish people, to be masters of our fate in our own state.